So now I'll be doing the second surprise dish for our Noche Buena. And I call it Chocolate de Batirol Fondue Halo Halo. Anything goes, anything you fancy. In my case, I'm using the traditional Christmas fare that usually comes out during the season. So the first order of business is to chop up the tablets, place them in a double boiler, and then pour milk. So I've done that earlier. And this is the consistency I'm after. Look at this, look how thick it is. With the double boiler, the pot is not in direct contact with the heat. That will burn the chocolate. So there's water inside the lower pot, and I'm going to make now the chocolate de Batirol. So instead of beating it here, it's faster using a blender. Pour some milk. And then some peanuts. These are spicy peanuts. So now I'm going to pour some of the melted chocolate. So here. Let's see. I'm after a thick consistency, but not as thick as the melted chocolate. So here, it's a bit runny, but still thick. So this is the chocolate de Batirol. Okay, so now let's pour this into the fondue pot. This chocolate de Batirol fondue, Halo Halo, has a second component. So this is a mixture of the chocolate tabea and extra virgin coconut oil. And in order to achieve a solidified chocolate coating, meaning you want a hard shell, don't even put any liquid like milk or water. So these are just two ingredients here. And from here, we're going to get some of the fruits. So the trick is really to dip it completely. So that's one banana. Let's do one chocolate dipped strawberry with crushed peanuts. Doesn't this look delicious? Look at that. I have this queso de bola chips from my friend Chona Aison. I'm gonna dip it like so, and then place it here. So after dipping it, you have to place this in the freezer for 5 to 10 minutes. And fortunately, I have this one ready, straight from the freezer. See, still, it's already frosted. Hard shell, I have to try one. Chocolate-coated strawberry with crushed peanuts. And the strawberry itself is frozen. I mean, half frozen, but the spicy peanuts and the chocolate. So from here, I'm gonna include it in my carousel. So here's my chocolate de Batirol fondue Halo Halo, ready for the Noche Buena. I just showed you two Noche Buena dishes that we'll be feasting on tonight and that you can include in your own Noche Buena with your own family. Of course, you can always add more to the feast, but let's save them for later and get dressed, because there's more to see in Angeles City on Christmas Eve. Let's go. Since the Noche Buena is prepared at home, let's go see what's happening in the city center. Christmas in the Philippines has always revolved around the church. So here we are now at the Holy Rosary Parish Church, or what we call Sambang Maragul, or the Big Church. It is considered a historical site built by the founding fathers of Angeles in the 1800s. And this is where we will attend the anticipated Christmas Mass with the rest of the community. Christmas is about celebrating the birth of Jesus, which is why there is always food outside the church. The yummiest Filipino snacks color the scene and warm our bellies, all in preparation for the traditional lantern procession, which we call Lubenas.
It culminates on Christmas Eve. That's the last. Processions are held in every barrio, usually with lanterns and the image of the saint and also other creatures. It's only the fish that probably stays up to nowadays. I think the San Fernando Lantern Festival has more attraction. But here in Angeles, we still have the traditional lantern made from Japanese paper and bamboo frames, okay, with its intricate design.
Being here, enjoying the celebratory atmosphere, this is part of our family tradition. This is our home, and we welcome anyone who wants to celebrate it with us.